we are called to hold on to the light. The plan, the call of God is, my son, my daughter, hold on to my light. If you don't hold on to my light, darkness will come. Enter into my light. Burn. Be prepared to be burned. Be prepared to shine. And be prepared to know the truth. You are here only for a while. This light, this grace, this power is available for you only for a while. In that time, if you don't touch, if you don't put your battery charging, the time is coming. There won't be electricity. You can't charge. You may feel like talking to somebody. You cannot. Because the charge will go away. You will go away from here. You will go into the theology. You will go far here and there. Nobody will empower you. You will have no time, first of all. You will be busy here and there. Your mind will be corrupted. Easily somebody will tell you, you will be out. This moment of grace, this moment of reflection, this time to know the truth, know about life, is a precious time. This is the time you have to torch yourself with the light of God. If you don't torch yourself with the light, the time is coming. Even if you wish, there won't be available for you. That time, the enemy will come and destroy us. That's why the word of God says, rise up and shine. Because the world is lying in darkness. The people of this world are covering with the darkness. But God has chosen you upon you. He has determined to give his light. He has determined to give you the truth, to hear his voice. There are so many people in the world. They didn't have that opportunity. That's why in the book of Hebrews, chapter 3, three places he says, when you hear the voice of God, don't close your heart like the foolish people in the desert. When they were walking in the light, Satan came in the form of Canaanites. Women, they were eating, they were drinking, dancing. And so many people, the Israelites, instead of walking in the light, they went for drinks, alcohol, and to dance with those women, to have pleasure with those women. And that is the end. What God gave to them, the gold, silver, the riches, the cattle, for them and for their family, they took it and gave it to those women. Take this gold, give me pleasure. Take my cow and give me drinks. Whatever God has given to you, Satan will want to make you zero. Satan wants to dry it up. And on the other hand, Satan will make you. The moment they sinned, all that Canaanite woman, with all men they went, all the sins were given to these people. When a man goes to a prostitute or to a woman, and all the sin of that woman goes into that man. Yes, they lost. The snakes came. Earlier, the snakes were no dare to come near them. Now, when they are in sin, they caught them, bit them, and their bodies were thrown into the desert. Because the family has moved, they said to the family, just you go, I am coming. So the family could not see back. Their bodies were thrown. The Bible says the word is scattered. Scattered means those snakes are bitten. And there will be certain animals in the desert. They caught, they were waiting for some flesh. They made them into pieces. Even if the family might have heard that your husband is dead, when they returned back, they could not have seen anything. That is the way enemy will do. His game is to humiliate you when you least expect. Take you where you don't want to. He will take you in the name of pleasure, this and that. and he will humiliate you, make you zero, and make you make fun of in front of everybody. That's why, while there is light, shine upon. The Lord is saying, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. That's why in 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 7, it is written, to strengthen yourself, get up. First, he gives us the food to Elijah. He gives the food to strengthen himself. Come on, get up and eat. He ate and drank and he slept again. God again in chapter 19, verse 11. Again he calls him, rise up. Now this time, not merely to feed and sleep, to train him. To train him. Now you get up and walk on the mountain. You have to face water, rain. You have to face the storm. You have to face the earthquake. But I'll be with you. So first God is calling us, rise up to come out of the evil, the problem, the situation. Then second time again he will rise us up to be filled with his power, with his glory for shining. One side is for burning, other side for shining. With the shining, you come as a witness to the world and give glory to God. This is the purpose for which God has called us. Close your eyes for a minute. Take till now what you have heard. God is calling you. Rise up and shine. Because Jesus says in John 9:4, while it's the time of light, we have to work. The dark time of darkness come when no one can work. It is the time of light when everybody can work, can enter into the light. But the time of darkness come, Jesus says, when nobody can work. The Father has given me only 3.5 years. Afterwards, even if I decide I can't do, this day, if I don't go to Capernaum, next time I'm not going to. I have no time. This is the time. If I am not filled with the Holy Spirit, I have no opportunity. This is the time. If I don't fast to myself and train myself, oh stupid man, stupid woman, where are you going? Where are you leading yourself to? What is the call of yours? Know the truth and build up the truth which will set you free. If you don't set you free today, tomorrow it is going to be impossible, because we will search for direction. Nobody will be there. The book of Amos chapter 5 says, there is a time is coming, time for the drought of the word of God. People will be hungering for the word of God, but those who give the word of God will not be available to them. Maybe they are dead, maybe they are transferred, maybe they are gone. While it is available, take care. It's the time of light. Don't roam around and throw away your life. Yes, John was a burning. He was offering himself. So all those who offer themselves to God are the persons God makes them to shine. To shine is not a desire. It is an outcome. If what you give, if you learn to burn yourself, you will see yourself as shining. If you are a shining, you will be a witness. To be a witness, you have to witness is the third stage. To reach the third stage of witness, you have to go through the first stage of burning. If you don't give yourself, if you don't give your time, if you don't offer yourself to that fire to burn away all the dirt from you, to burn away all the thorns from you, to burn away all that is not of thine, not of God. If you don't give yourself, if you are not burnt, you cannot shine. If you cannot shine, you can't be a witness. God is calling us.